Welcome to Valley Children's Healthcare Level 4 Epilepsy Care Center. Valley Children's is the only hospital in Central California to be named a Level 4 Epilepsy Center by the National Association of Epilepsy Centers, or the NAEC. Level 4 Epilepsy Centers have the professional expertise and facilities to provide the highest level medical and surgical evaluation and treatment for patients with complex epilepsy. Our epilepsy monitoring unit, commonly referred to as EMU, is a designated area for our epilepsy patients who need to be monitored over longer periods of time. Valley Children's Epilepsy Monitoring Unit is a safe place where you will come for your video EEG or electroencephalogram. What is a video EEG? Even during sleep, our brain cells are always active and communicating through electrical signals. To show this activity, a non-invasive test called an electroencephalogram, or EEG, uses electrodes that are attached to the scalp with a special paste and secured with medical-grade glue. These electrodes connect to a computer or monitor through colored wires, which record the electrical activity of the patient's brain. The computer then translates these recorded electrical signals into visual patterns, resembling wavy lines, which are reviewed by your neurologist. When is a video EEG used? A video EEG is a valuable tool for diagnosing and tracking various brain conditions, but its primary purpose is to detect and examine epilepsy, a disorder characterized by recurrent seizures or episodes thought to be seizures. By performing a video EEG, your neurologist can figure out the specific type of epilepsy you have, if the questionable events are actually seizures, identify potential triggers for your seizures or events, and devise an effective treatment plan. Additionally, a video EEG study allows your doctor to see your child's brain activity and body movements during a seizure by studying recorded video footage. What should we expect during a video EEG? You will meet your electroencephalographic or EEG technologist once you arrive at our EMU. You should plan to stay overnight in the hospital for at least 24 hours, but sometimes up to 5 days. During this time, your child's brain activity will be monitored on video the entire stay. When you and your child arrive for the study, you will be taken to the EMU where you and your child will stay in a private room during your time at the hospital. Here, staff will gather information from you about your child's current event types and seizures, verify any medication, and review the current plan of care for the stay. Your child will be asked to change into comfortable clothes with a button-up shirt and lie in their prepared hospital bed. Your EEG technologist will gently prep the scalp with a prepping solution to remove any dead skin cells. While your child is relaxing, a total of 23 electrodes will be placed carefully on their scalp using a specialized paste and then secured with a medical-grade glue. 2 electrodes will also be taped to their chest or shoulders to monitor their heart rhythm. This setup process typically takes 45 minutes to 1 hour. Once all 23 electrodes are glued on the scalp, they will then be connected to the EEG recording equipment by the attached colored wires. Throughout the hour, your EEG technologist will use this time to get to know your child by engaging them in conversations about their interests and activities to help them feel at ease. Once the video EEG recording has started, the technologist will have your child perform activation procedures such as hyperventilation and photic or light stimulation, depending on the patient's age and level of cooperation. How will the test feel? It is crucial for your child to understand that they should not experience any discomfort during an EEG. This procedure is painless. While the electrodes may feel sticky and unfamiliar on your child's scalp, they should not cause discomfort. It is common for children to mention feeling an itch on their head while the electrodes are being placed, which is normal. Your child will be asked to relax and remain as still as possible during this time. You can be a source of support for them and help them stay calm by speaking and interacting with them. Once the setup is complete, you or another adult caregiver who knows your child's seizure history well will need to be in the room with your child for the entire stay. You will be responsible for marking when you believe your child's seizure begins by pushing a button provided for you at the side of their bed. The recording is always on, but your input is helpful for the doctor to understand when you believe your child's seizures occur. If your child has a seizure during the procedure, your nurse will enter the room to provide any needed medical care. Your EEG technologist does not always enter the room, as they may stay in the monitoring room to document the event. Your nurse will ask questions to check your child's level of awareness, memory, and ability to follow directions during and after the seizure. This information will help your neurologist in determining which part of the brain is affected during the seizure and the severity of the impact. Nursing staff will give seizure emergency medication if needed per the doctor's orders. How do we prepare for an admission for video EEG? To make sure the test process goes smoothly, please follow the given instructions when scheduling your appointment. These typically include refraining from using conditioner, oils, sprays, or gel on your child's hair after washing the night before the test. If your child has glue and extensions, remove them beforehand. Your child's neurologist may recommend that you temporarily stop certain medications prior to the test. Do not make any changes to your child's medication without consulting your provider. Bring a list of your child's current medications with you. Follow any other specific instructions you are provided with. What can I bring? Please make sure to pack these items: comfy clothes, a button-up shirt for your child, activities to help keep you and your child entertained, snacks, and bottled water for parents, as you will be unable to leave your child's room during the entire stay. A special blanket, stuffed animal, or other small comforting items. If your child is still taking a bottle or sippy cup, or you are breastfeeding, please bring a bottle with you. And please bring a list of your child's current medications. What happens after our EEG inpatient stay is complete? After completing the test, your EEG technologist will take off the electrodes and adhesive by using an oil-based remover. Their hair will then be wiped with warm water and baby shampoo where the electrodes were placed. In most cases, you will need to wash your child's hair several more times once you are home. There may be some temporary skin irritation or redness where the electrodes were placed, but this should go down within a few hours. Your neurologist will inform you when you can restart taking any medications if they were stopped before the test. During your stay, the neurologist will review the recording of your brain waves and talk with you, making any necessary adjustments to your treatment. It is important to remember that the EEG may detect abnormalities in your child's brain, even if a seizure does not happen during the test. What are the risks of an EEG? The EEG test has been used for many years. It is considered a safe procedure. The test causes no discomfort. The electrodes record brain activity. They do not produce any sensation, and there is no risk of getting an electrical shock. We hope this video will better prepare you and your child for a stay in our epilepsy monitoring unit. We look forward to seeing you soon. Please reach out to the Neurology Testing Center with any questions or concerns prior to your stay.